हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एंड नो हाउ अ पल्स ऑक्सीमीटर वेल वर्क्स एंड हाउ टू यूज इट एट होम। अ पल्स ऑक्सीमीटर इज अ सिंपल डिवाइस। यूजुअली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फिंगर टिप पल्स मीटर विच इज पोर्टेबल एंड स्मॉल डिवाइस एंड इट इज यूज टू मेजर ऑक्सीजन सेचुरेशन ऑफ द ब्लड एंड पल्स रेट। सो दीज बोथ data are given by this small machine. So how does this pulse ox works? Let us try to understand. Just assume that when you go somewhere, a passenger is sitting in a taxi. In a similar way, the oxygen which we inhale is transported to all over the body by a car. Just assume that there is a car which is of hemoglobin. So it is of blue color when there is no oxygen, but it becomes red when there is oxygen. So when there is only blue hemoglobin, there is no oxygen, the saturation will be shown as 0%. When there is 50% occupancy, it will be 50%, and similarly when it is 75%, it is 75%. So this is a pulse oximeter. Pulse oximeters are of various types. It can be finger probe like this one. It can be Mosimo or it can be Nalcor, which are used in the hospital as bigger machines. There are many types of pulse oximeter. You can buy any one that you want. Try to avoid cheaper Chinese versions and try to go for branded in these times. There are pencil cells on the back of it. So it has to be operated by a button which is switch off, switch on. The position of button may vary as per your device. And a menu for what you want to see, pulse or oxygen level and alarm will be there. So that accordingly you can adjust. So after it starts out, if there is low battery, then low battery alarm will be shown. So after you start it, check the battery also, and if the battery is okay, then only the readings will be good. If you hear low battery alarm or the device doesn't work properly or fluctuates frequently, you need to change the battery. Also try to cross check the device at the shop only. So there are two ends, one is the receptor and one is the light source. So we have to insert the finger and the light should come from above, that is through the from the nail side. So in some devices the display can be on the opposite side where you have to rotate the hand, but in all these devices the light should come from above and the receptor should be on the opposite side. So these are the two readings. One is the saturation of oxygen, which is written as SpO2 and is in percent. The second is PR or pulse rate, which is written as BPM or beats per minute. So it is very crucial. There are many things that one can use in any finger. It is rather immaterial. However, if possible, try to use in middle finger because it has double blood supply, so slightly better reading will be obtained. Also try to keep the device on for at least 40 to 50 seconds to get perfect reading. Sometimes if you keep it for brief time, the readings may be inaccurate. It takes around 1 minute to stabilize. Also, if you move the hand frequently or if you are not sitting still, the readings won't be accurate. So always measure pulse ox by maybe 2 or 3 times per day and keep a record in it. If there is any home isolation patient in it, keep a diary for the record. So this is a very simple instrument and very good instrument, very easy to use, readily available. So don't be shy to purchase one. You should also purchase a thermometer and mask as usual for prevention of COVID-19. So now this is a chart for helping you to understand it. The above one is alarming situation where saturation has dipped to 67% and heart rate is 42. So this is very, very alarming. So first, when you see this picture, correct the position of the hand. Sometimes the position of the hand or finger is not good, or you're moving fast, it can show error. Otherwise, if it is this situation, rush to your doctor and seek medical help. The lowest curve is the usual graphic presentation that you should get. The graph should be regular and pulse ox should be somewhere between 95 to 100, and heart rate should be somewhere between 60 to 100. Now, how does a pulse oximeter work? The pulse oximeter, as told earlier, it has a light source and a light detector. So the light passes through the finger and gets the specific spectrum gets absorbed by the hemoglobin. So the more oxygen is there, the more light is absorbed, and this absorbed light leaves some amount of light which goes to the opposite end, the left wavelength, and this way the measurement is done sensor. Also note that if you are using the pulse oximeter in very high level of light or outside in sunlight, then the room light and the red light from the receptor overlap and the readings will be misleading. So try to use the pulse oximeter in simple room, and if you are not getting good readings, cross check by switching off a few lights if your room. Similarly, use of color, dye and nail polish or henna or mehendi will not give you accurate reading. You have to remove them. Some patients have different types of hemoglobin. Usually they will know if they have wrong or other type of hemoglobin. So they might be getting wrong reading. So usually these patients are aware of their own situation.